In this introduction video, we will discuss the various parts of a solar cell and the losses that occur in a solar cell. All these losses and the physical processes behind them have been discussed in the PV1X photovoltaic energy conversion course. The learning objectives for this video are to understand the main function of the various parts of a solar cell. We will discuss the main losses that occur in a solar cell, and you will learn how these losses lead to the design rules for solar cells. Shown here is a standard silicon wafer-based solar cell. We will discuss crystalline silicon solar cells extensively in the first 2 weeks of the course. These are the most common type of solar cells on the market. We will base this solar cell on a P-type silicon absorber, even though some silicon cells can be made with an N-type absorber layer. The purpose of this absorber layer, as its name implies, is to absorb light. Through this absorption, minority and majority charge carriers are formed. In the case of a P-type absorber, electrons are the minority carriers and holes are the majority carriers. Next is the emitter layer. The emitter layer is crucial for the charge carrier separation and collection. The emitter layer functions as a selective membrane that allows minority charge carriers, in this case electrons, to move through. The membrane resists the movement of majority carriers, in this case holes. Without the emitter layer, generated charge carriers would simply move around in the absorber layer until they recombine. Similarly, at the back of the solar cell, we have the back surface field, or BSF. This acts as a semi-permeable membrane for majority charge carriers, in this case, holes. With the BSF and the emitter, we can separate electrons and holes to either side of the solar cell. In order to collect these carriers and send them to an external circuit, metallic contacts or electrodes are needed at both sides of the solar cell. When the solar cell is connected to an external circuit, the excited electrons will flow through the circuit to recombine with the holes at the other electrode. Only a small fraction of the front surface is covered by electrodes. Charge carriers therefore have to move laterally to the front electrode. In a high-quality crystalline silicon solar cell, this lateral charge carrier movement takes place in the emitter layer. For many PV technologies, however, the conductive properties of the emitter layer are too poor for good lateral transport. For these technologies, a transparent conductive oxide layer is introduced that is transparent to the incident light but has excellent conductive properties. You will learn more about TCOs later in this course. Finally, an anti-reflection coating is placed at the front of the cell to reduce the front surface reflection and maximize the light transmission into the cell. As we have seen in the preceding video, the current record crystalline silicon solar cell efficiency of about 20.6%. This means that 73.3% of the incident energy is lost through various mechanisms. Let's take a look at these loss mechanisms. The losses that occur in solar cells can be divided into optical losses and electrical losses. By far, the largest losses occur due to spectral mismatch. Spectral mismatch considers the notion that any single junction solar cell can only use a fraction of the available spectrum. If we consider, for instance, a crystalline silicon solar cell with a band gap energy of 1.12 electron volts, which corresponds to a wavelength of about 1100 nanometers. Photons with an energy below the band gap do not have enough energy to excite an electron from the valence to the conduction bands, since there are no allowed energy states in the band gap. These photons simply pass through the semiconductor material. The semiconductor material is essentially transparent to photons with an energy lower than its bandgap. Below bandgap, photons are therefore lost due to non-absorption. If, on the other hand, the photon has an energy greater than the bandgap energy, some of its energy is lost as well. Upon absorption of a photon, the valence electron will be excited high into the conduction band. Shortly after excitation, however, the electron will relax back to the conduction band edge. The excess energy is thereby converted into thermal energy. This process is called thermal relaxation or thermalization. A single junction crystalline silicon solar cell can therefore only use the fraction of the AM1.5 spectrum indicated by the brown area. The spectral utilization strongly limits the conversion efficiency of a solar cell. In practice, there are additional optical loss mechanisms. We will continue our discussion of the optical losses and the electrical losses in solar cells in the next video.